So I'm Naseer. So we'll be seeing the Moodle installation. It's e-outreach program from IIT Bombay. So the outline of this program is we'll be starting with the requirements of Moodle, the hardware and software requirements, and how to set up MySQL database, creation of Moodle data directory, followed by how to install Moodle in Ubuntu using apt-get command, and setting up web server, configuring Moodle, and using LDAP authentication in Moodle. So introduction, Moodle is an acronym for Modular Object Oriented Dynamic Learning Environment. It is primarily developed in Linux using Apache, MySQL and PHP, called LAMP platform, Linux, Apache, MySQL, PHP. It is even tested with Windows XP 2003, called WAMP platform, and many other operating systems also. And it supports other databases like Oracle, Postgres, Microsoft SQL Server, etc. So the minimum hardware requirements for installing Moodle is you need to have minimum 160 MB of free space, and it depends if you want to show more data like assignments, user images, then you need more space. And the minimum free space required is 256 MB, and 1 GB is recommended. For every 1 GB of memory, 50 concurrent users can access Moodle and 500 users can browse. Concurrent user in the sense you can they can upload assignments and they can store files, etc. And 500 users can browse. So if you have 2 GB of memory, 100 users, concurrent users, and 1000 browsing users can be ports. And software requirements for installing Moodle is you need to have some web server. And the most common web server is Apache, and it even supports IIS web server, any web server that has to support PHP. And for if you are using Windows, then IIS is recommended. And the MySQL database, which you have already installed. So you need to first set up MySQL database. You can install MySQL database using MySQL server, apt-get install MySQL server, which you have done right now. So we'll be creating the Moodle database and the Moodle user in the MySQL. So login into MySQL using MySQL username as root with password. So once you login into MySQL, you need to create a Moodle database for a Moodle user. So you can do it by create database. Create database Moodle. That's a default. Character set as UTF-8. Enter this command in the MySQL prompt. It has created a Moodle database, and you need to give privileges for the database. We are creating a username called Moodle user for accessing the database. Moodle user at localhost, identified by your password. Enter some short password. Moodle db passwd. And then run the next command, grant select logs. Select log table. even you have to create a Moodle backup user for backup purpose. And give some Moodle backup password also. I am giving it as Moodle BKP password. Then flush privileges. So the Moodle user and Moodle database is created and all the privileges have been given. So after the Moodle database creation, we'll be starting with. So right now, for installing of Moodle, you need to have Moodle data directory where the user can, or user or any other teachers can store the critical information like assignments or any other files. So you need to have some directory which is protected, that is secured. No other user should read that directory. So you need to create a directory. We are creating a directory in extra, make by using the command make directory Moodle data. The permissions of this Moodle data is 755 and the owner and group are root. The permissions are 755 and the owner is root and the username group is root. So the browser may not get the permissions for accessing the Moodle data. So you need to change the owner and group of this Moodle data so that it is accessible only by the Apache user. So change the permissions of this Moodle data by using the command chmod 750 for Moodle data. This sets the permission of Moodle data. This is the permission. Right now we will be changing the group and owner and group of Moodle data. Using the command chown hyphen r, that is for recursive, www.data. This is for the first part is for owner and the second part is for group. So the owner and group of Moodle data has been set. So that it is secure and other, it cannot be accessed directly by some other means. And you can even protect your Moodle data directory using by creating a file called .ht.htaccess. This prevents the this has the file directory permissions. So in this file, you create a create a file called .htaccess. In this, enter the information order deny. So this file even takes care of the security permissions. Vim, create a file called vim space. Yeah, okay. It has to be in Moodle data directory, inside Moodle data. So do cd, it has to be in Moodle data, cd Moodle data, and there you do .htaccess. So just create a file .htaccess inside Moodle data directory and write this information. What? For security permissions of Moodle data, so that no other user directly access the Moodle data by entering the path in the URL and seeing the files.
So
this.
Yeah,
so for Apache user, he takes care that only www.data user is able to access that particular Moodle data directory and no other user can access that.
So that
is and
deny.
Yeah, deny.
And for allow?
Allow for www.data user, and we have set the ownership and group for the directory. And that is the configuration of Apache. So once you have given the privilege for Moodle data, you need to install Moodle right now using the command apt-get install Moodle. You can even download the source package and install from there. In Ubuntu, it's easier. You can use the apt-get command. So this gives the screen. You have to select the web server for configuring Moodle. Select Apache 2 as the web server and select MySQL server for database, and database server name, server host name as localhost, and database administrator username as admin, and password as admin password, something of your own, and confirm the password. Now create a username for Moodle database owner and let it be Moodle itself, and password, you enter it as Moodle DB password, yeah, this is a different password. So it's a kind of like first giving all user information and re-enter the same password. So initially while installing, you need to note down all these usernames and passwords because it's very confusing later on. Yeah, you can keep the single password, and if it goes to anyone, then it will be hacked. You can access all the database, everything. Yeah, so this initially we have created a database of for Moodle, but we have not created any tables. So the Moodle will create the tables while installing itself. So just log, we need to log into open in the browser, we need to open the page localhost Moodle admin. So for till now the creation of Moodle database and the Moodle user is been finished. So while when you open the page of localhost Moodle admin, it will actually create the tables for Moodle. So just type admin. This is the page what you get when you enter localhost Moodle admin in the browser. This is the actual process where the Moodle tables are created. You need to agree for the terms and conditions of Moodle. Then continue for this. And here it's creating all the database tables that are required for Moodle. So setting up databases. It's creating tables like example MDL, grade preferences, everything. So you need to have all success for this Moodle tables. So database was successfully upgraded, groups, database, everything upgraded. So continue the process. Database connection failed. Yeah. So what you do is apt-get remove Moodle once again and then follow the procedure, because you might have forgotten some place at least. Just enter this command for removing the Moodle database package. Moodle package. And then start with Moodle apt-get install Moodle. Whatever you have set for the database admin. What?
For
I didn't get you.
Should we use the one that we set for MySQL?
No, what you have set for the password you have set in the text boxes that appeared, MySQL DB password.
Is this something new that you get?
Yeah. Let me start. So you have got this screen, Apache 2, MySQL server, local host. Okay. Database administrator username. Enter this on your paper somewhere. Admin. And password as localhost. Before this, after this, after this. Here database administrator username admin. Just type some password admin. Re-enter the password. Confirmation. Now enter Moodle user. We have created the Moodle user while after configuring the MySQL database. We have create database model. We have created a database model and we have given the privilege for Moodle user. So enter Moodle user there. And Moodle owner password as, keep simple, some Moodle itself, because you may not be confused. And for re-enter the same password. Okay, everyone got this screen. Localhost Moodle admin. Now open the browser and type localhost Moodle admin page. Fine. So open this file vim user share Moodle config.php. So check if you have entered the correct database password. to know the database password, you can log into MySQL. So first enter the command mysql minus u username root and password, then just see the previous commands what you have entered. You have given the privilege for Moodle user identified by some Moodle password. So this password has to be same as in the case of config file of Moodle. So just open the run this command mysql minus u root and see the your pass commands what you have given the password for Moodle. Grant all privileges on moodle.star to Moodle user at local hash identified by Moodle password. So once you get this Moodle password, check if it is same in the config file. Correct. Config file is at user share Moodle config.php. config.php. In config.php user share Moodle config.php, you need to enter at set it at Moodle DB password. So give the correct database password. Give the same password what you have set it here, identified by MySQL Moodle DB password. It should be the same. Once you correct this, everyone done?
You have to change this one to Moodle password.
Moodle DB password, what you have given the password identified by here, the same password is to be written. You got how to know what you have entered?
Command line.
The file name? This one? Yeah. So at the command prompt, you enter this MySQL minus u. Then check your previous commands by your top key, arrow key. You have given grant all privileges on moodle.star to Moodle user at localhost identified by some password. That password is to be the same in the config file. Done with that. So after that, open the page in the browser localhost Moodle admin. http://localhost/moodle/admin. And continue. If all the this should show that all the database creation table creation should show the success. Continue with it. You can continue further. Continue further until it completes all the installation of creation of tables. Yeah. So this is, there is a page for configuring Moodle admin information. Continue, continue. So you have to be careful here. Here you have to enter the password which you will be using for entering into Moodle as an admin user for controlling all the activities. So better decide your own easy password, admin password. I am giving it as admin itself, fairly simple. Email, you give your any email address. It will not check whether it is valid or not, but if any like anything is going wrong, then it will try to mail at this email address. So it's better the Moodle admin give the valid password, a valid email address. Enter the information, select time zone. So enter the admin password, enter email address, city and country. If you want, you can keep your own information here at this place. You can update your profile at any time further. Then update your profile. So you will get the screen for front page settings. Yeah, update profile, Moodle. Just enter full site name for your Moodle. I am entering for as Moodle for IIT Bombay workshop, and short name. This will be appearing in your front page. And in the description, in the front page, usually the list of courses will be seen. So it's better not to show all the courses. So it's you select the list of categories. This will show like in IIT Bombay, we create each a separate category for each semester. So all these categories can be seen in the front page. So front page list of categories for any user, and list of categories for even the logged in users. Save changes for this. So you will get Moodle for IIT Bombay workshop, everything. This initially a miscellaneous category has been created. Hope everyone got this page. It's fairly simple, just you have to take care of the usernames and passwords of everything, database and Moodles. You can change your front page settings even later on, whatever we have added right now. You can change the appearance. Let me select this reference, it's up to you. And if everyone has set up LDAP on their own system, then you can create configure LDAP setup in Moodle. First you need to enable LDAP setup, LDAP in Moodle. This enables this, and in the settings you need to specify the server settings and all the details. So I will be describing about this right now. If server has been successfully set up, or LDAP server has been set up on your system, then you can use it. So enter host URL as LDAP :// and your IP address. IP address of your machine. You can check your IP address from this if config command. And select the version for LDAP as 3 because you have installed LDAP 3, version 3 UTF-8. In bind settings, hide the passwords because it's usually store the passwords in the database, so you have to hide it. Just recommended. And in the user lookup settings, you need to enter the LDAP what settings we have done while installing LDAP. So user attribute as UID. Before this, in user type you have to select POSIX account RFC 2307 BIS. And in context, achha, if you are not getting it, let me repeat this. In this page, enter host URL as LDAP colon slash slash your IP address. Version 3. Hide passwords. Select the user lookup settings as, in user lookup settings, select user type as POSIX account RFC 2307 BIS. In the context, enter your LDAP settings, what you have done while installing. Yeah, DC is equal to my. So first enter OU is equal to people. DC is equal to my domain. This is what you have created, and DC is equal to com. OU is equal to people, comma DC is equal to my hyphen domain, what you have entered for your LDAP setting, DC is equal to com. Then enter the user attribute as UID, member attribute as OU, member attribute uses DN as CN equal to manager, DC is equal to my domain, DC is equal to com, CN is equal to manager, DC is equal to my domain, DC is equal to com. Now in the data mapping, the bottom data mapping, this is actually used for mapping the LDAP data into Moodle. So what it will do is, whatever the usernames you have been given in the LDAP, that will bring from the LDAP and store in the Moodle database. So the for the first name, LDAP stores in UID. So enter your first, so in the Moodle database the first name will be stored as UID that is fetched from the LDAP, surname as CN, if you have any other attributes in LDAP, then you can enter those attributes here. First name as UAD, surname as CN. That's it. Save settings. In IIT Bombay Moodle database, we store many other attributes that have been fetched from LDAP. And in LDAP, many attributes are stored for every user. Its ID number, city, town, department, email address, everything. Save changes. And disable this in common settings, disable self registration. What it will do is any person can log in into Moodle with some username as a guest by creating a new username. You can give instruction. Hope you got this. Then save changes.
Disable.
After that, in the instructions, just give some instructions whatever required, and then save changes, and then log out from the Moodle, and you can test for your LDAP user created, like student one is been created in the LDAP. Password is student 123. So initially, if you don't have any valid email address, then it will ask the user to update his profile. Enter some email address. If this attributes are set in LDAP, then it will not ask the user to enter its own details. So update the profile. Yeah. So this is the student login. Initially no courses has been created, so it's not enrolled. With admin, you can create categories, you can create courses, assignments, everything, and all this has been explained in the previous lectures. And let me give some insights of configuring web server and Moodle. Come to the terminal prompt, user prompt, root prompt. Open the file /etc/etc/apache2 conf.d Moodle and just go below some 10 lines. You will see that here we have restricted the users from other users accessing the Moodle. So you can, if you want to allow access from other machines, you need to comment this deny from all and allow this, so that your Moodle can be accessed from other hosts. Right now we were accessing the Moodle from our local host, the same IP address. If you want to open Moodle of some other host, you need to set a task allow all and comment out deny from all. So you can test your neighbor's Moodle also by entering the URL. After that, you need to restart. So that all the settings are been taken care. You can see your memory usage in hard disk space using the command df minus h, and the Moodle data whatever we have created is not taken by the Moodle. Moodle has created its own Moodle data directory. So Moodle has created its own Moodle data directory in slash var slash lib. This is the Moodle data directory that is created by Moodle. So you may not be having much space in your slash var. So you, we have created another directory in slash extra. You can configure this path, Moodle data directory path, in your config.php. So that if you do not have space in one directory, you can, in the config file, you can reset it for some other path. You can see the config file in slash etc Moodle config.php. So open this file, vim etc Moodle config.php. Here the data directory has been given as var lib Moodle. So if you know, if you do not have space by default in var directory, then you can change the change to any other space like slash extra Moodle data, what we have created earlier, and we have set all the permissions for that. So right now I will not be explaining how to by changing the data directory. So we have created Moodle, we have set up LDAP. These are the references. Let me give a survey of IIT Bombay Moodle. The Moodle source code is of approximately 50 MB, and if we want any changes for our institute, then we will usually change the source code on requirement basis. And database size is 600 MB. It grows how much you store information and from how many years you are using everything. And Moodle data directory current Moodle size is 8.5 GB, and total users right now are 11,000 plus, and total 1800 courses, more than 1800 courses are running in IIT Bombay in Moodle. And the configuration of the server is, we have allocated 4 GB of RAM, we have given 4 GB of RAM, and it has many other applications also running that is like more complex than even Moodle. So with 4 GB of RAM, it can easily handle it. And the server is Intel Pentium 4 with 3.2 GHz. So any desktop machine can be used as Moodle